Hello everyone! So 2021 is almost over, which means that 2022 is almost here. And with that, fingers crossed nothing happens, Hogwarts Legacy. Now don't worry, if you're here on my channel only for the Hogwarts Mystery content, I'm not going anywhere, I'm not switching teams, I'm, if anything, simply adding to my workload. Fridays will still be Hogwarts Mystery content days, whilst Tuesdays will be for videos on Hogwarts Legacy. There might be some other videos as well, randomly throughout the week, depends, and the schedule Tuesday, Friday might in general also be a bit loose, because I do have a 2-month-old to take care of, so for me time is kind of a relative term. Same as for Hogwarts Legacy developers. And whilst I'm fully aware that there have not been any news on Hogwarts Legacy since the trailer came out forever ago, it doesn't mean we can't talk about it. It doesn't mean we can't discuss what we want from the game, what we want to see, what we expect to see, what we think is most likely going to be in the game, what may be excluded. So what better place to start than what every Harry Potter game has ever started with, aka the Sorting Ceremony. So if we go to the lore, at Hogwarts, the sorting was initially done by the four founders themselves, but upon realizing that it's not really a sustainable option, they instead enchanted a hat that would make the decisions for them. Hence the sorting hat that we know and love. At Ilvermorny, which is the North American Witchcraft and Wizarding School, the student, upon arriving at the school, would step on a Gordian knot that was placed at the entrance of the school in front of four wooden statues representing the mascots of the four houses of the school, and then the mascots would choose which house the student belongs to, and on the rare occasion that more than one house wanted the student could then choose by themselves which house they want to belong to. So it was essentially the voice. Now, in the Muggle world, of course, there is no magical power that can look deep into our souls and really uncover our true nature. And if there was such a power, the GDPR would probably put an end to it rather quickly. So the developers are left with a tough decision, figuring out how to replicate this experience. Now, there's of course several options already in existence. For example, in Hogwarts Mystery, see, I did not forget about you even in this video, the player can simply choose which house they want to belong to, and that is that. Very simple, very quick, very easy. On Pottermore, or WizardingWorld.com as it is known now, there is of course a quiz that you take to determine which house you belong to. Is that a better way? Well, it's definitely more involved, it's definitely more advanced, but still rather easy to, if not cheat, then to give the answers we know will put us in the house that we want to be in. So, plus, as the quiz already exists, should it be placed in a video game? Should we even have that in a video game at all? And should we have two different or similar quizzes in existence if there already is one well established? So what should the developers do? There is a third option that, well, it is an option. Let's just put it that way. There's a possibility that we start our gameplay with a quest, and depending on our choices, depending on the way we decide to complete the quest, we are then placed in a house of the game's choosing. Now that would definitely put us on edge and definitely make the reveal and the determination of the house a surprise. But ironically, do we really want to be surprised? Do we really want that? What if we are put in a house that we feel doesn't really suit our nature? What then? Like, won't that kind of ruin our gameplay experience? So if that's not really what we want, and the quiz already exists, are we really left with just, once again, just choosing the house that we want? But maybe they will add a bit of a twist to that. Now, if we go to the Hogwarts Legacy website, and for that I will put on my glasses and take my laptop, there might actually be a hint to what they plan to do regarding the sorting. So you can see the following house descriptions actually on the website. So you've got the Hufflepuff who mastered Herbology, the Gryffindor who grapples with Graffons, the Ravenclaw who dared to discover, and the Slytherin who soars with Hippogriffs. And besides these, there's also a few that are not assigned to specific houses. The Potionaire who mixes with precision, the one who defies dragons, and the Befriender of Beasts. Now, if we assume that we do get to simply choose the house, but they do want to keep the experience kind of unique and just interesting, what if choosing the house means more than just the color of our robes and the location of our common room? What if we do actually get to have a specific, unique gameplay that is designed for each house? I mean, after all, in the books, the house is like your family and it will help you improve yourself and cherish the skills that you have. And it would just make sense that in this video game, once you choose your house, it does actually kind of determine the future of your gameplay, what abilities you will be able to master, what skills you will be able to improve. So is that what they're doing? Is that what we want? I think that's what we want, because whilst we may not want to be like completely thrown off by being put in a house that we don't feel is our own, we do want a little bit of that surprise. We do want a little bit of anticipation and a little bit of unexpected. And yes, we definitely want unique experiences that go far beyond, yeah, the look of a common room. We want more. Is that what we're gonna get? We're just gonna have to see. If you have your own expectations, your own vision, your own idea of what the sorting might be at Hogwarts Legacy, write that in the comments. Let's start a discussion, because that's all what we can do right now. As I said, there are no news. So all the videos until something comes out on this channel will be basically me just rambling and talking about what I think could happen. But, you know, we like to do that. And we like to hear what other people think, don't we? So that's it for this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next week. Bye.